What is going on, guys? D-Blake here, and today I'm super excited to bring to you the Fall Winter 2017 accessory collection for Supreme. You can check out everything on their website, but I wanted to go over the accessories because it's definitely one of the strongest accessory lineups of all time, in my opinion. So definitely let me know down in the comments which ones you're looking forward to. And we got to start off with the best piece, in my opinion, the Fender Stratocaster guitar. This is crazy. To see something like this come from Supreme is super cool to me. You can also see that it comes in some special packaging. This is definitely going to be one of the more sought after items, especially if you're a musician. Unfortunately, it probably also end up in a lot of people's homes just on display. Between the packaging and obviously collaborating with a brand as crazy as Fender, or as well known as Fender, definitely something iconic for Supreme. Along those lines, they also have an Artek tank chair, some well-known furniture designer. Going to be interesting to see what they mark these up on, but you know, I have no doubts that it's going to be quite expensive. This has a all-over fuck print, very similar to the Love statue in New York City, or the Rage Against the Machine album, depending on what you're into or what you think came first or after. They also have this cash paperweight. Now, what's going to be interesting about this is if it literally has cash inside it. There's very strict laws about reprinting money. So if it looks very similar to real cash, it has to be obviously done in parody. Now, that could be the Supreme band around the front of it. But if it is, in fact, a literal cash paperweight with actual cash inside it, it's going to be, one, interesting to see what they retail it for, and then, two, who actually buys it, because then you're going to pay the premium on top of the cash, and most people aren't going to crack it open. I guess maybe it might get really desperate for some people, but it's going to be very interesting to see, kind of like the ultimate flex piece that you can afford to literally keep money inside of a paperweight and do nothing with it. We also have a Supreme Everlast satin robe. They did a couple things with Everlast, two different prints. Again, something most people are probably going to end up wearing around their house. I don't see too many people actually boxing in this as a warm-up, but really, really cool. And they use the Everlast licensing to also do a exercise mat. So you have the full kit and caboodle. You could do your aerobic exercises, or like most people, most likely just hang it on their wall. They also did a collaboration with Woolrich. These are wool throw blankets made for your couch, whipping on your Crate and Barrel. Done deal. Shit, says a lot about your personality. And then, of course, we get into some of their jewelry. So this is going to be a $100 bill gold pendant kind of accompanying the banknote that we saw earlier. And then, of course, something that a lot of people are looking forward to. You know, we've already seen the fade jokes on Twitter and everything like that. But this is an Andy Supreme blade clipper. So, of course, you can now get your haircuts. If your barber's trying to really, you know, outdo themselves, they can add this to their arsenal. This is really cool. Someone actually sent me the packaging for this a little bit earlier. I didn't know if it was going to come out next year or this, but it's cool to be seeing that it'll be coming in this drop. They also did a Bang & Olufsen, one of the most premier, even more so than Bose audio makers. And this is going to be a Bluetooth speaker. Expect that to be quite highly priced. And then for you survivalist out there, we have a Supreme and SOG collaboration. This is a collapsible trench shovel. So pretty cool accessory right there. Now, if you picked up the Longevity bowl set, you might want to get the chopsticks to accompany it. These look like they're going to be enamel, not wood, so you can get a lot of use out of these. I like the packaging on these too, but in keeping in line with the soup bowl and keeping in line with the chopsticks, we also have a ceramic sake set. There's also going to be a gold trim ceramic ashtray. In addition, we're also going to see a Tough mug, another collaboration, so some thermos, keep yourself warm or hot during your long camp out. And then there's also a Mophi Encore Plus, so even, you know, they keep kind of upping the ante on how long you can recharge your stuff as the lines for Supreme keep getting longer and longer. You also have a lock box, going to be not that big, about the size of a small tackle box. You have a safety sack. Now, I don't know quite what that is. Nylon with embroidered graphic, woven label, leather trim, keyed locked closures. Yeah, so, I mean, not that that's going to really deter too many people from just cutting open your sack and taking the money from it, but if you're into that, you can get it. They also have shooting sleeves. This is wild to me. This is awesome. Official collaboration with Nike. So we'll see if they actually do a release on another Nike basketball model this season. That'd be interesting, but kind of welcoming in Nike's partnership with the NBA, we now have a shooting sleeve. snakeskin belts. We're getting into some of like the lighter accessories. There's also a welcome mat. There's nothing here worth dying for. That's actually pretty dope, in my opinion. They're going to be doing the Real Tree camo with Hanes, so kind of upping the ante a little bit, and likewise with the boxers. And then, of course, we'll see the flannel packs. We also have the Arabic logo neoprene face mask, which is going to be coming out. Face masks were very, very popular. And they're doing a Polar Tech logo on this scarf that they did. You also see the shit bandana, so similar print that they did with Woolrich, although this is not a Woolrich collab. And then you have a diamond cut Zippo set. Going a little faster here, but Supreme and Nightcore mini magnet flashlight. We also are going to have a Quiet Carry knife keychain. This is one of the better knife keychains that they've done, in my opinion. I like that it's rectangular in shape, just kind of a little bit more prominent. I got the house key one from last drop. And then this sled. This is awesome. The Supreme sled. This is something I think a lot of people have been looking for them to do. Just kind of, to me, brings up a, like that classic red sled. You know, like why Supreme didn't do this before, I'm not sure. But definitely going to be probably one of the more anticipated items for this season. They also have an inflatable blimp. Does it float? Most likely not, unless you put helium in it, obviously, but it looks like it's meant to be inflated and then hung. You also have a Fuck the President, I Pledge Allegiance to Shit, United States of America keychain. That's great. See You in Hell Supreme Coffin keychain with a little bit of a trap door, and you can hold a cigarette. A handcuffs keychain. When I first saw those, I thought those were actual handcuffs big enough for all your kinky endeavors, but unfortunately they are not. And then you have a Gons keychain here. And almost done now with the keychains, another embossed keychain, and then a Blood and Semen skateboard by Andre Serrano right there. So that's going to be one of the deck sets for this season, in addition to the Gone set that they're going to be doing. So let me know what you guys think for this collection. Let me know what your favorite pieces were, and let me know what accessories you're looking forward to most down in the comments. And if you're interested in more, we always tweet out the early links as well as the upcoming drops on Clothes Under Cost and Kicks Under Cost Twitter. So if you want to follow those, you can. I will catch you guys soon with more information. T-Blake signing out. Peace, guys.